So with the new year coming, you may already be thinking about calendars. And there are the decorative calendars that you may have around your home, but you may have more functional calendars, say for work or for your home office, that you can write on, scribble on, put on notes, or maybe print out with information you already have in your calendar on your Mac. And there's a great print function in the calendar app on your Mac. Here I am in the calendar app and you see I've got a couple of things here on my home calendar. And I say I want to print this out. I want to have something for January. I go to File, Print, and I want to change View to Month. And you can see it prints up a pretty nice looking calendar here. I can customize it in a number of ways. So for instance, I can say there's certain calendars I don't want to be on there and certain ones I do. Or I can just turn them all off and have a blank calendar, which is kind of handy if you're trying to plan something out and want something on paper that you can scribble on. You can choose what type of events to be on there. So for instance, I can say, you know, I don't want any timed events, events that are a specific time, just all day events there, or vice versa. The mini calendar is what's up here, and you can turn that off. And the keys are the little codes here that show you what calendar each event is on. So let's say if something starts at January 2017, and we'll print 12 months out to December 2017. And you can see the color codes here and you can see these little codes. I can change text size to big so you can see a little bit bigger. You can see it's blue right there to match the home calendar blue. I can turn off the calendar keys so they're gone if I want. Save a little space. And I can zoom in here if I wanted to see what the calendar is actually going to look like before I print it. It's really handy because it's a nice looking calendar. I mean, it gives you a lot of nice space to write in. I've used this before to plan long trips, just printing out that month so I can write on the calendar some ideas I've got. And then afterwards, when everything is already in the calendar app, I can then print it out and have a printed copy to take with me of everything going on and what days they're on. You can also do some things after you hit continue. Then it goes to the print dialog here. You can choose your printer, but you can also go ahead and look at the details. If you don't see all this stuff, it's because you have to hit the Show Details button here. And you can see I've got 12 pages that will be printed. One of the cool things you can do here is go to Layout and change it to say 2 up. And then you have 2 per page or even 4 up like that. So that's really handy for printing something really small to bring with. So a lot of different options there for printing out kind of functional calendars that you can have right now out of your printer from the calendar app. You could even do things like say if you know, you just want a calendar of all the birthdays, then you have your birthdays calendar turned on. It's grabbing birthdays from your contacts and then you could see that on your calendar. And that's something you're not going to get on your pretty calendar that you buy at the mall. And you can also create a calendar that's specific to things that you want to be on a printed out calendar. Like say maybe the days you're planning to take off from work in the next year, you know, vacation plans, things like that. Print out the calendar and be able to have a copy of it posted on the wall for you to see maybe in your kitchen or something away from your Mac. So take a look at the monthly printing functions in the calendar app as the new year comes to us and see if you can use them to create something useful